Good day. Here are the stories for the Manila Times for Monday, February 15, 2021. The Supreme Court wants the Judicial and Bar Council to relax its rules in the selection of a Chief Justice, a move seen by some to favor Associate Justice Mervic Maria Victor Leonen because it would give him the perfect camouflage to cover his shortcomings as a magistrate. In a five-page en banc resolution dated February 9, the court recommended the easing of the rules for screening nominees for Chief Justice. The council is tasked with preparing a shortlist for nominees and submitting it to the president. In the resolution, a copy of which was obtained by the Manila Times, the court asked the council to exempt from the obligatory interview the five most senior magistrates who are prospective nominees for Chief Justice. Also to be waived is the submission of a magistrate's medical and psychological records, bank accounts, caseloads, and the complaints against the applicant. The Supreme Court issued the resolution just weeks before Chief Justice Diosdado Peralta retires on March 27. Peralta's departure will leave the court with five senior justices: Leonen, Estela Perlas Bernabe, Alfredo Benjamin Cagiwa, Alexander Hismundo, and Ramon Paul Hernando. Any of them could become the next head of the court. Chief Presidential Legal Counsel Salvador Panelo slammed Transportation Secretary Arthur Tugabe and other officials of the Department of Transportation for their inaction in the controversy over the motor vehicle inspection system. Panelo, in his commentary show Counterpoint, said Tugabe should have addressed problems arising from new policies being implemented by the DOTR's attached agencies at this level so as to not burden President Rodrigo Duterte. He admonished transportation officials to shape up or ship out. Former U.S. President Donald Trump was acquitted on Saturday or Sunday in Manila of inciting the horrific attack on the United States Capitol, concluding a historic impeachment trial that spared him from the first ever conviction of a current or former U.S. president, but exposed the fragility of America's democratic traditions and left a divided nation to come to terms with the violence sparked by his defeated presidency. Barely a month since the deadly January 6 riot that stunned the world, the Senate convened for a rare weekend session to deliver its verdict. Voting while armed, National Guard troops continued to stand their posts outside the iconic building. A 7.3 magnitude earthquake off Japan's Fukushima prefecture injured dozens of people, authorities said on Sunday, nearly 10 years after the eastern region was hit by a huge quake that sparked a tsunami and nuclear meltdown. Prime Minister Yoshihide Suga said no casualties had so far been reported after the late-night quake, which did not trigger a tsunami warning. Metro Manila mayors will submit a formal notice opposing the national government's decision to allow movie theaters to reopen, the Metro Manila Development Authority, or MMDA, said on Sunday. MMDA Chairman Benher Abalos said the mayors were drafting the notice it would send to the Interagency Task Force for Management of Emerging Infectious Diseases, or the IAT of EID. He noted that movie theaters are enclosed and air-conditioned spaces where people stay for more than 30 minutes, conditions that increase the risk of COVID-19 transmission. The World Health Organization have cited studies showing that people who share enclosed spaces for approximately 1 hour with symptomatic COVID-19 cases were prone to catching the virus. The Commission on Elections on Sunday announced that it would extend voters' registration hours for the May 9, 2022 national and local polls. James Jimenez, director of the Education and Information Department of the COMELEC, in a statement said, starting on Monday, voters' registration would run from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m., Tuesdays to Saturdays, including holidays, a two-hour extension of the previous 3 p.m. cutoff. The purpose of the extension is to help bolster the number of voters for the May 2022 election. There will be no registration on Mondays because it was designated as Disinfection Day, mandating all COMELEC offices nationwide will be closed. Topping business, the Bureau of Internal Revenue has listed various strategies to attain its 2.08 trillion peso collection target this year. In a statement over the weekend, the Department of Finance said Internal Revenue Commissioner Cesar Dulay told Secretary Carlos Dominguez III that the Bureau aims to increase its collection by 7.23% this year from the 1.94 trillion pesos it raked in 2020. He said the BIR will raise its collections by improving tax compliance among all taxpayers, strengthening its budget management system, speeding up its recruitment and promotion of employees, expanding its computerization efforts, and further intensifying its enforcement such as Oplan Candado, run after tax evaders, and tax audits. Staying in business, Europe's financial capital is feeling the cold of Brexit, but UK officials insist the City of London is suffering a temporary blip and is well positioned to profit from new trading horizons. For the first time last month, as Britain's withdrawal from the European Union took full effect, London's financial district lost its European share trading crown to Amsterdam. In sports, Ignite head coach Brian Shaw leaves the decision of approving or disapproving Kai Soto's bid to rejoin Ignite to the NBA G League authorities and the Ignite management. The 7'3" Soto left Ignite to join Giles Pilipinas in the third and final window of the FIBA Asia Cup qualifiers. But with the cancellation of the event in Qatar and the final schedule of the competition, now back in the Philippines, won't be finalized until after 10 days, the 18-year-old Soto decided to go back to the United States and rejoin Ignite. Soto left the Philippines for the States on Sunday. He still needs to undergo COVID-19 tests and quarantine once he lands in the United States. Rigoberto Tiglao and Father Ranilio Aquino are today's front page columnists. Tiglao believes National Task Force to End Local Communist Armed Conflict, or NTF-LCAC, spokesman and fellow Times columnist Lieutenant General Antonio Parlade is a hero, while Father Aquino thinks about love on what he calls Valentine Day. Today's editorial believes Congress should think before leaping into virtual marriage. Read the full version on the paper's opinion section or listen to the voice of the Times. For more news and information, get a copy of the Manila Times on print, subscribe to its digital edition, or log on to www.manilatimes.net. Follow us on Twitter, Facebook, or Instagram, and keep up with the Times. With the Fort Villaseran, this is Arik John Sikwo reporting. May have a safe week ahead.